Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and in this short video we're going to be creating a footer that changes the year every year automatically using JavaScript. So why don't we jump into CodePen and get straight to it? Okay guys, so here we are in CodePen. I just want to get you just to check a few things while we're here. So if you go to your CSS, the settings cog at the side, give that a click. And make sure you have normalize and auto prefixer on in here. Save and close. That will just make all the browsers act the same. The paddings and the margins are reset, so they're not all different, okay? So let's start creating this footer. We're going to be using emit again. So instead of typing out full tags like this, we can just type in footer and hit the tab key, and it fills it out for us. Just makes it a lot quicker. You should be able to find that on your text editor if you're using the big ones. It should be an extension in there for emit. So, what do we need to do next? Let's statically write out our copyright information. And first of all, we need a copyright symbol. And that is a code. And the code for that copyright symbol is ampersand, copy, semicolon. Then you can write whatever. So I'm going to write RichardCodes, give it a date, 2018. All rights reserved. And there we have it, statically written in. But it's not looking too much like a footer at the moment, so let's change that. So let's jump into our CSS and type in footer, give our curly brackets, and let's move it to the bottom first of all. So position absolute, and that is saying I now need specifics of where you want me to be. So I want it to be bottom, 0 pixels from the bottom. There goes, jump to the bottom. Right, the next thing, I want to give it a background color. The background color that I picked is 2E, oops, sorry, hashtag 2E3B53. It's a nice blue color. There you go. But you notice that it's not the full width. So let's make this footer width 100%. So we're getting there, but you can't really see the information. So let's change the color to white. And that's the font color. You just use color. Now let's put this text in the middle. So let's do that by using text align. So text align center, and that should throw it into the center. And now let's just pad it out a little bit of padding on top and bottom. And we can do that by saying padding 16 pixels. And we have got left and right padding on there because we haven't specified top and bottom, but that kind of works what we're doing. And if the browser shrunk, it's nice to have a little bit of padding at the side and the text not to be touching the sides. Right, okay, so that's our footer done. So let's work at getting our date and injecting it in between these footers. So the way we do that is, let's grab our footer first. So let's say on the documents, get elements by tag name, because we haven't got an ID this time. And the tag we want to grab is footer. But because we can have multiples of the same tag, what we now need to do is we need to say if there's another tag on this page with the same name, because it's not an ID, right? If there's multiple tags with the same name, you need to pick the first one. So we're saying 0. We have to specify this, even though there is one. Now we say dot inner HTML, which will let us change what is inside the footer tags here. And we want to change that to something. So we want to change that to, let's say year. And we're going to now create that variable called year. So jump up at the top. Let's create that variable year. And this is how we get the date from JavaScript. We create something that constructs us a new date object. And how we do this is we used a new keyword. So we want a new capital D date parentheses close. And you can see now it's given us this funky long-winded date, time, even our time zone, right? And that's a great place to start because now we can dig down into it to find what we want. So there's methods we can apply to this year to get what we want. So we can do things like dot get month, and that gives us a numeric value of the month, number one being February, because obviously zero is January, because it's standard zero. And the one we want is dot get full year parentheses 2018. Now there's a list of these on the Mozilla MDN. I'll link that below so you can check out what other ones do. You can get hours, minutes, seconds, time zones, all by just adding extra onto the end of your new date. So adding an extra method will get you extra things. So now we need to build up this copyright information because we're just giving it a date at the moment. So why don't we create another variable called date? Let's set that to equal string literal, so backticks. So now we can inject variables in the middle of strings. It's just a lot easier. So we want to use that copyright symbol. So and copy semicolon. Then whatever you want to write, RichardCodes. I want to put my date in here. So the way we inject a variable into a string literal is dollar symbol, curly brackets, then the name of the variable. So in this case, we have year. I'm going to go full stop. Then I'm going to say all rights reserved. Close up that string with a semicolon. And now all we need to do is change this year to date instead. And we should have our dynamic footer. There we go. Now every year your website gets to January the 1st, this will automatically update so you don't have to go back into your code and do it. And look, hey, I've got some spaces here, but that's three lines of code. That isn't going to hurt you every time you're going to make a footer to do that. You could wrap your date up here just in span tags, and instead of rewriting a string here, because I can delete the string here now, right? So instead of rewriting the string out in full, you could just inject the year, and instead of injecting into the footer, you could inject it into the span. So that's another way you could do it, but it's such a simple thing, you might as well do it. It doesn't cost you any time really to do it, and it's a little cool thing that you can use in every project. Okay guys, so that's us finished for this video. I hope you enjoyed this small video, this little video that I find this little stuff interesting, little things that don't take too long and you can kind of code along. So please like and subscribe. And any comments, let me know if there's things you think I could do better, there's things you want to learn and you want me to have a go at teaching them, feel free to just drop a comment and we will try to do that. But anyway, for the time being, guys, thanks for joining me and I will speak to you soon.